course, there is I think that one of the main advantages of the Egyptian economy is that it is multidisciplinary. It is not relying on a specific industry or a specific sector. That's why I believe that if we can concentrate together about where is the areas that we can see that there is this potential of growth together and envisioning how we can strengthen our relations and expanding. Definitely, I will start by saying manufacturing. To really make use of this huge market of Egypt, which is 100 million inhabitants, of course, again, to make use of Egypt as a gateway for Africa and the Middle East. And making use of our skill and, of course, the cheapest labor that we have here in this country. So manufacturing, it's really, for us, is very important. And as I have been hearing your, of course, speech, when you have spoken about availing land for industrial purpose, I don't know whether my colleague here, the Minister of Industry, has had the chance to explain to you what is the big steps that we have done recently under the direct supervision of the cabinet of availing all lands in the country, which is really allocated for the purpose of industrial development online, so that now you can access our official website and you can make all your procedures and administrative and even pay for the down payment of the land, which is now it's availed in all over Egypt. The prices is there, the condition of payment is there, the purpose of development is there. So I really invite all of you to have access of the website there. And there is a lot of portal that it is, you will find it linked together. If you go to the website of the Ministry of Investment, the Cabinet, Ministry of Industry, you will find all of this access to land is there. So manufacturing, of course, is very important. Of course, the very strong and traditional sector of petroleum and natural gas, but I would add, of course, the petrochemical. And this is very important, and I was very delighted and very happy with my colleague, the Minister of Petroleum, who see for the first time ExxonMobil that will start investing in the upstream. And this is for us is really crucial and a very good sign how Egypt is very attractive to this, I can call it global companies, not only American companies, to come and invest in Egypt. I think the third one, which I believe is the future, is the telecommunication and information technology. We have our vision for 2030. Egypt, again, is very privileged with its young population, very skilled people who can be really, I think, very competent to serve not only Egypt, but the whole region and even the globe. And we have very, I think, successful stories about how foreign companies here has managed to even use Egypt as a global basis for their investments here. And I believe, again, my colleague here and my brother, the Minister of Telecommunication, has very good success stories about this sector. I think the agribusiness, again, is very crucial and very important having what's happening here in Egypt. And last but not least, I would, of course, speak about transportation. Here we are having a very old and ambitious plan to rely more and more heavily on public transportation and more smart mechanism for transportation. I'm here speaking about the different sectors, of course, the sector of power, but I believe my colleague, the Minister of Electricity, will say we have already surplus now of generating powers, and now we are very selective and very peculiar in selecting our partner now in this field, because we started, thanks God, to have the luxury of having surplus of our generation of electricity. But again, of course, we have very ambitious plan in the sector of renewable energy. And as we are speaking now, I think we are about to reach even more than 20% of our resources coming from renewable energy. And His Excellency the Minister has put a target in 2013 that Egypt will even have around 40% of our power coming from renewable energy, which is a very ambitious and bold plan, but we are working very hard, and even we are on track, we are not lagging behind. So these areas, I believe, all of them now can represent very attractive fields for more and more American and Egyptian investment.
Prime Minister, clearly over the past 5 years, we've turned the page, and all the economic problems are positive and hopefully getting better as we move forward. You eloquently gave the statistics during your presentation on where we were, where we are, and hopefully what are the aspirations moving forward. If you factor in as well the sustainable development vision for Egypt 2030 and opening up opportunities for the business sector both locally and internationally, and the measures that have been taken by the government to make it more competitive, more agile, more inviting. Let me just ask one question. What remains to be the biggest challenge?
I think the main challenge of Egypt in the coming period is human resources. And here I'm speaking about improving the quality of life for Egyptians, but most importantly, to change the mindset and the culture of the Egyptians, to try to make them more productive, more open to global markets, to less relying on governments.
It's more mindset.
I'm speaking here on the mindset. And this will not happen without focusing more and more on education. And this is our target. And we have, of course, very bold program to improve the education, and we started to implement it already, even with all the criticism and, of course, the dialogue that's taking place here in the society about it. But we believe that this is the right track, and we will continue to do it, because we believe that this is for the sake of the Egyptians. And this is what we have learned from all the experience that has taken place in other countries, in similar countries. Maybe you can try to focus in a short period if you would like to really achieve a big growth in investing in infrastructure, construction, making mega projects as we are doing now to really boost the economy and really putting and injecting more and more money different sectors so that you can create more jobs and all of these kind of things. But without starting at the same time a very bold program in improving education so that you can really equip the new future generation with new technologies, with all the, of course, the means and tools to really be adaptive to the global market, then you will have a problem. And this is, I believe, our main challenge here in Egypt, to change the mindset, the very old mindset and traditional mindset of Egyptians that have been, again, I can say, this is the era, of course, the legacy of the socialist era in the 50s and 60s on deeply relying on the state and everything. And we have to really, again, equip the Egyptian people, the youth, with all the tools and means to really be surviving and really succeeding, not only in Egypt, but even in any other places where they can succeed.
Last question, Minister. You just spoke very eloquently about changing the cultural mindset of the generation of Egyptians and how you want them to step forward into the economy and grab opportunities. At the same time, all of us, we have a problem in the United States, as you probably have here. There are never enough jobs. And an interesting thing struck me this morning in listening to a very very sophisticated set of presentations about the things that our government is doing to stimulate the economy, technical solutions, things that are going to, that are not just IT, but it's going to be AI, and it's going to be a variety of systems that, in fact, reduce the number of jobs that are available in the name of productivity. What, it's a struggle and a challenge in the United States, and I'm sure it is a struggle and a challenge here. How are you looking ahead to thinking about jobs in general? The fact that you have a growing population coupled with an increasingly sophisticated population that you want to step up and you want them to grab jobs, what do we do to make sure that there's something for them to grab?
Very sophisticated question, I can believe, a very complicated one, but I believe that with at least for the coming 10 years, Egypt will continue to rely on the main traditional sectors that is leading the Egyptian economy, but gradually, of course, major sectors like communication, ICT, and of course, data, artificial intelligence will gradually start, as any other places in the world, to prevail. And we know very well that there is specific jobs that will disappear and diminish from the whole economy. But at the same time, we know very well that tens of new jobs and opportunities will start to emerge to really adapt with this. We are not that concerned with this. And again, my main concern is to really put the tools in the hand of the youth to really be adapted to all of these dramatic changes that will happen. And that's why I was saying that the issue of education, the issue now of introducing, and this is what we are doing in our higher education, introducing new curriculums, new faculties, new universities, even focusing on subjects and new sciences, the issue of technological universities, and really again I'm returning here to changing the mindset of the Egyptians, because the issue of tech, what we can call it vocational education and technical education here in Egypt, it was perceived with a very lower grade. But now what we are trying to introduce with this technological universities and imposing the technical education, things are changing now, because now the Egyptian families started to realize that when you enter in your, whether your son or daughter in these universities, immediately they will get jobs. Much better even from the traditional universities. So things are changing, and we are not concerned that much with that, because Egypt still has a very wide span to grow. I cannot, of course, compare Egypt with the United States, because the United States, as Europe also, they reach their maturities in terms of development, in terms of... But for Egypt, still we have a long way to build our country. So the issue of being buzzing about this kind of jobs and all of these kind of things, I think definitely it's very important, but we believe that still we have a very wide room in the coming at least 2 decades for the Egyptian to really find jobs if we really run our economy in the correct manner. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you very much, Prime Minister. I think you wrapped it up. I always call Egypt, I mean, people are the oil of the 21st century, and we don't have a problem there. I mean, 100 million accounting. So you're putting the strategy around investing in human capital, from awareness, educational training, to education and the like, and that will obviously affect all sectors of the economy. So thank you very much for joining us today. Please, let's give a round of applause for the Prime Minister. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for joining us today. This wraps up the U.S.-Egypt Future for Prosperity Forum. Thank you for being here. Thank you for sharing your thoughts, either across the papers or with the panelists throughout the day. And we look forward to seeing you in the next agenda. Thank you.